The lighting gets so bad. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing the This or That challenge. This was inspired by Nikki Tutorials. If you haven't seen the This or That challenge here on YouTube, you should definitely go check it out. She's an awesome makeup artist and she's super natural with the camera, so it kind of makes you feel like you're her best friend. So today's video is inspired by her. Basically, for this challenge, there's going to be three lists, and in each list, there will be items that are then put into pairs, and I'm going to choose which one I would prefer or like. The three lists that we're choosing from today are makeup, body, and hair. So I'm super excited. If you guys want to see this little challenge, then just keep watching. The first pair that we have for makeup is blush or bronzer. I would definitely pick bronzer because it just makes me feel like a little bit more tan and chiseled as to if I just wore blush without like contour or a little bit of bronzer, I would feel completely washed out. Lip gloss or lipstick? Now this one was kind of hard because I do have a little bit of a collection with lipstick and lip gloss, so it was hard to choose, but you guys know me. I totally went with lip gloss because I can't go without a glossy lip. It just looks so good to me, and when you have your eyes popping or it's natural or whatever, the lip gloss always just tops it off. Eyeliner or mascara? You probably can't tell on camera, but I have a little bit of mascara on. Obviously, I would have to choose mascara over eyeliner because I feel like the eyelashes just make your eyes pop. Foundation or concealer? This was also a little bit difficult for me because I feel like with concealer you can kind of do the same thing as foundation, except, you know, not put it all over your face, but you can definitely like spot conceal. But I'm gonna have to go with foundation because, you know, if I was only able to wear one thing forever, like a piece of makeup, it would have to be foundation. Neutral or colored eyeshadow? I'm going to choose neutral, but I have gotten into more colored eyeshadows recently. I'm definitely a lot more open to colors now than I was a few years back. I have to go with a good neutral. Like I said, like a neutral eye look with some lip gloss, that's my go-to. Pressed or loose eyeshadow? I'm gonna have to go with pressed. I have a bunch of loose eyeshadows and they work perfectly. They're amazing. I absolutely love them and they have so much pigment. But I would have to say majority of my palettes and things like that are pressed. I would have to choose that. Brushes or sponges? I have a ton of brushes, which I love. One of my favorite ones that I ever got were from Coastal Scents, and I think it was a 22 pack or a 22 set, and it came with a bag and everything, and those were my prized possession. After I got the Professional Beauty Blender, it changed my life. Like, I just can't go back. Like you guys see in my videos, I use the brushes, and I honestly haven't used my beauty blender as much as I do off camera. I know that sounds weird. I feel like the brushes give me more of like a full coverage look. Even though the beauty blender is supposed to be amazing, it does soak up a lot of product, and when you clean your beauty blenders, you can tell because there's so much product that comes out and it almost feels like it's never ending. It is a sponge, so it does soak up all the bacteria and dirt and things like that into the sponge, but I'm gonna have to go with it. Okay, the next category is body. Now there's like four questions in this one, so let's just go ahead and get to it. Perfume or body spray? I had to go with body spray because I use it more than I do perfume, but I absolutely love perfume and it obviously stays for a longer duration of the day. Lotion or body butter? This was hard just because I have a lot of lotion and I have a lot of body butter, but out of the two, I like body butter because it makes my skin just feel so moisturized. Body wash or soap? I would have said body wash like a few months ago, but I will say ever since my boyfriend and I have been using the African black soap, I think it's called. I'll link it down below if you've never heard of it or if you've never seen it or if you want to get some. So soap. Lush or any other bath company? Any other bath company is probably Bath & Body Works, and I have to go with Bath & Body Works because as much as I love Lush and all their awesome little bath bombs and things like that, it's one of my favorite places to go just because they have such a huge selection. All right, so that was it for the body category. Now we're moving on to hair, and this is the last one. Curly or straight? I would have to go with curly hair, as you guys can see. I just love it more natural now, and it just feels so much better. My hair is healthy. It's finally getting to a good length, and I just want to keep it that way. Bun or ponytail? I have my hair in a bun like maybe 90% of my time that I'm around people. Bobby pin or butterfly clips? I've always used bobby pins. Dance, like, you use bobby pins a lot. I would have to go with bobby pins. Hairspray or gel? I would choose gel over hairspray because it makes my hair, like, hairspray makes my hair so crunchy. Or, like, if you've never sprayed hairspray and just smelt the fumes, your hair is bound to be dry after that. It's just, it smells like, I don't know, dry hair in a can. Long or short hair? So I've had short hair for quite a while. This is not necessarily short hair, but to me,
this is short hair because I had very, very, very long hair before. And like, as a kid, like, I just always had long hair. And then, you know, I grew up and I decided I wanted to chop all my hair off, which is totally my fault, not anybody else's.
Okay, seriously, I never got to the point, but I meant to say long hair. Light or dark hair? I like light. I'm gonna go with light. My roots are here. It's dark. It's very dark. I have dark hair. But at the bottom here, my hair gets lighter because I was a dumbass and decided to dye my hair. Side swept bangs or full bangs? I had full bangs and I actually cut them myself. I'm pretty sure I watched somebody on YouTube, but mine did not turn out to be a fail. In my eyes, it was maybe not the cutest thing on me, but I did try it out and I really liked it. But I'm gonna have to go with side swept bangs because that's always been one of my favorites, and they're so cute when they just slide to the side. Up or down? I'm guessing that meant just, do you like your hair up or down? I'll say up because, again, I always wear my hair in a bun. So, all right, guys, this is the end of today's video. I had so much fun and it was really cool because it was kind of about me, but I didn't have to go into like depth or answer dumb questions like, where do you live? What's your name? How old are you? If you guys enjoyed this makeup tag or makeup challenge, this or that, just comment down below and like this video. If you haven't subscribed already, please do, because you guys can enjoy more videos from me. I'll be posting on Monday and Friday. I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.